Oh, Namah Bhagavate. Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 4, chapter 8. Dhruva Maharaj leaves home, text number 17.
我们学习圣典波加瓦坛第四天第八章第十七世节。
Dirgam
Dirgam
Swasanti
Swasanti
Vrichanasya
Vrichanasya
Param
Param
Apashyati
Apashyati
Balakam
Balakam
Aha
Aha
Mama Angalam
Mama Angalam
Tata
Hata
Pareshu
Pareshu
Mamsta
Mamsta
Bhonte
Bhonte
Jano
Jano
Yat
Yat
Para
Para
Dukadas
Dukadas
Virgam swasanti vrijanasya param
Virgam swasanti vrijanasya param
Apashyati balakam ahabala
Apashyati balakam ahabala
Mam angalam tata pareshu mamsta
Mam angalam tata pareshu mamsta
Paradukadastat
Bhunte chanoya paradukadastat
Dirgam swasanti vrijanasya param
Dirgam swasanti vrijanasya param
Apashyati balakam ahabala
Apashyati balakam ahabala
Mangalam tata pareshu mamsta
Mangalam tata pareshu mamsta
Bhunte jano yat paradukha dasta
Bhunte jano yat paradukha dasta
Dirgam swasanti vrijanasya param
Dirgam swasanti vrijanasya param
Apashyati balakam ahabala
Apashyati balakam ahabala
Mam angalam tata pareshu mamsta
Mam angalam tata pareshu mamsta
Bhunte jano yat paradukha dasta
Bhunte jano yat paradukha dasta
Dirgam swasanti vrijanasya param
Dirgam swasanti vrijanasya param
Apashyati balakam ahabala
Apashyati balakam ahabala
Mamangalam tata pareshu mamsta
Mamangalam tata pareshu mamsta
Janoya paradukadasta
Yonke janoya paradukadasta
Dirgam swasanti vrijanasya param
Dirgam swasanti vrijanasya param
Apashyati balakam ahabalam
Apashyati balakam ahabalam
Parishu Mastha
Mamangalam Tata Parishu Mastha
Bhunte Jano Ya Paradukha Dastha
Bhunte Jano Ya Paradukha Dastha
Dirgam Swasanti Vrijanasya Param Dirgam.
Dirgam.
Heavy.
Heavy.
沉重.
沉重.
Swasanti.
Swasanti.
Breathing.
Breathing.
呼吸.
呼吸.
Vrijanashya.
Vrijanashya.
Of the danger.
Of the danger.
危险的.
危险的.
Param.
Param.
Limitation.
Limitation.
限制.
限制.
Apashyati.
Apashyati.
Without finding.
Without finding.
找不到.
找不到.
Balakam.
Balakam.
To her son.
To her son.
对他的儿子.
对他的儿子.
Aha.
Aha.
Say.
Say.
说.
说.
Bala.
Bala.
The lady.
The lady.
妇人.
妇人.
Ma.
Ma.
Let there not be.
Let there not be.
不要让.
不要让.
Amangalam.
Amangalam.
Ill fortune.
Ill fortune.
厄运.
厄运.
Tata.
Tata.
My dear son.
My dear son.
我的儿子.
我的儿子.
Parishu.
Parishu.
Unto others.
Unto others.
对别人.
对别人.
Mamsta.
Mamsta.
Desire.
Desire.
欲望.
欲望.
Bonte.
Bonte.
Suffer.
Suffer.
受苦.
受苦.
Jana.
Jana.
Person.
Person.
人.
人.
Yat.
Yat.
That which.
That which.
Na.
Na.
Paradukha.
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 Who is apt to inflict pain upon others?
Who is apt to inflict pain upon others?
倾向于使人受苦的人.
倾向于使人受苦的人.
That.
That.
No.
Translation. She also was breathing very heavily, and she did not know the factual remedy for the painful situation. Not finding any remedy, she said to her son, "My dear son, don't wish for anything inauspicious for others. Anyone who inflicts pain upon others suffers himself from that pain."
他的呼吸也相当沉重，他不知道该怎样扭转这痛苦的局面，于是对自己的儿子说：“我心爱的儿子，不要期望他人遭难，害人者反而害己。”
There's no purport. We'll read the next text.
这里没有要旨，我们继续学习下一个诗节。
Text 18. Suniti said, "My dear boy, whatever has been spoken by Suruchi is so, because the king, your father, does not consider me his wife or even his maidservant. He feels ashamed to accept me. Therefore, it is a fact that you have taken birth from the womb of an unfortunate woman, and by being fed from her breast, you have grown up."
苏尼基说：“我亲爱的孩子，苏鲁奇说的都是事实，因为你的父亲君王并不把我当成是他的妻子，甚至是一个女仆。他觉得娶我让他丢脸了。因此，事实是你由一个不幸的女人所生，并喝她的奶长大。”
Again, no purport. Text 19.
我们继续学习19节。
My dear boy, whatever has been spoken by Suruchi, your stepmother, although very harsh to hear, is factual. Therefore, if you desire at all to sit on the same throne as your stepbrother Uttama, then give up your envious attitude and immediately try to execute the instructions of your stepmother. Without further delay, you must engage yourself in worshipping the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
亲爱的孩子, 你的后母所撸起说的话虽然尖刻刺耳，但却是事实。因此，你如果想真的跟你的同父异母的兄弟乌塔玛一样坐在王座上，就要立刻去除嫉妒的心态，立即努力按你后母的指示去做。你必须崇拜至尊人格手神的莲花族，不要再拖延。
Purport by Srila Prabhupada. The harsh words spoken, the harsh words used by Saruchi to her stepson were true, because unless one is favored by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, one cannot achieve any success in life. Man proposes, God disposes. Suniti, the mother of Dhruva Maharaj, agreed with her co-wife's advice that Dhruva engage himself in the worship of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Indirectly, the words of Suruchi were a benediction for Dhruva Maharaj, for because of the influence of his stepmother's words, he became a great devotee.
要指白圣帕，是来自于圣帕帕德，苏如喜对她丈夫的另一个妻子所生的儿子说的是事实，因为人除非得到至尊人格守神的支持，否则不可能在人生中获得任何的成功。俗话说，谋事在人，成事在天。朱瓦马哈拉杰的母亲苏尼提同意与她共有一个丈夫的女人的提的建议，即让朱瓦马哈去崇拜至尊人格守神。苏如奇的话对朱瓦马哈拉杰来说是一个间接的祝福，因为他受后母所说的话的影响，成为了一位伟大的奉献者。
Om Ajnanatimirandasya Gyanjana Shalakaya Chakurnirandina Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhisyam Stapitam Yena Buddhale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati SwapadantikamVanneham Shri Guru Shri Yata Pada Kamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamsya Shri Rupam Sadrajatam Sahagana Ragnatam Vikam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Sahadutam Parichana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya DevamShri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakha Nikamsya Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpade Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostate Tapta Kanchana Gorangi Radhe VrindavaVrishabhanusuti Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vairacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaurabhadra Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
So we're hearing about this pastime, this encounter, this incident which took place in the palace of Maharaj Uttanapada.
我们听到这个逍遥时光是发生在这个 Uttanapada 的皇宫里面。
Maharaj Uttanapada was one of the sons of Manu.
Maharaj Uttanapada 他是 Manu 的一位儿子。
So he became a very great king with a wonderful big kingdom.
因此他有一他成为一个巨大的这个国王里面的国王。
And he had these two wives, one is Suniti and one is Suruchi.
他有两个妻子，一个叫 Suniti， 一个叫 Suruchi。
And Suniti is not, she's the mother of Dhruva Maharaj.
Suniti 是 Dhruva Maharaj 的母亲。
And the other lady, Suruchi, is the mother of a boy called Uttama.
而 Suruchi 呢，是另外一个小孩 Uttama 的母亲。
So they both wives have a child.
两个母亲都两个妻子各有一个儿子。
But the one wife, Suruchi, is more favored. The king likes her more than Suniti.
这个国王更喜更喜欢。更喜欢 Suruchi 比这个 Suniti，
and it resulted in Suruchi speaking very unkind words to Dhruva Maharaj。
由此 ，Suruchi 对这个 Dhruva Maharaj 说了非常不友好的话语。
When Dhruva was trying to sit on the lap on the knee of his father, Suruchi stopped him。
当这个 Dhruva Maharaj 想坐在他父亲的腿上的时候，Suruchi 阻止了他。
And she told him, "You cannot sit there."
然后他就跟他说，你不能坐在这里。
You are not born from my womb.
因为你不是从我的子宫里所生。
If you want to sit there, you should. You have to go and worship the Lord and take birth again. And next life, if you're born from my womb, then you can sit.
如果你想坐在这儿，你必须去崇拜至尊人格守神。在下一世的时候，你可以从我的子宫里出生，由此你才可以坐在这儿。
So we heard yesterday how Dhruva Maharaj was very upset by the nasty words.
昨天我们学到了 Dhruva Maharaj 他是如何被这些话语所刺激的。
And he went crying to his mother.
他向他的母亲哭泣。
So.His mother was also upset to hear about the incident.
他的母亲也非常悲伤。
But she knew that she could not do anything about it.
她非常失望，因为她知道她对这件事情不能做任何事情。
So we hear that her giving very nice advice to Dhruva Maharaj.
我们看到她给了 Dhruva Maharaj 一个非常好的建议。
She tells him first of all.That he should not be envious.
首先，你不应该嫉妒。
When somebody has something we don't have, we will envy them.
有些时候，我们不喜欢一个人的时候，我们就开始嫉妒他。
Just like Sishupala.
就像西树帕勒。
Right? He was always trying to compete with Krishna.
他总是想和 Krishna 竞争。
He was always wanted to try to be better than Krishna.
他总是想和 Krishna 比较，他想比 Krishna 更好。
So, even when Sishupal he was going to marry Rukmini.
甚至西舒帕他想跟 Rukmini 结婚。
And the marriage was arranged and it was about to take place.
这个婚礼呢，就准备马上就要发生了。
But just before the marriage, Krishna came and kidnapped Rukmini.
就在这个婚礼的前发生之前 ，Krishna 就把 Rukmini 给劫走了。
So it was a great insult to Sishupala.
所以呢，这对西施泡来说是一个特别大的事件。
侮辱。Insult.
Okay.
So Sishupala was from the beginning of his life, he was always trying to.With Krishna.
西树泡从一出生的一开始的时候就想和 Krishna 进行竞争和比较。
But he could never, of course, Krishna is Bhagavan. You cannot defeat Bhagavan.
Krishna 是巴格万至尊，他不可能和至尊进行。
No, Sishupal in his previous life, he had been Ravan.
西树泡在他前面的这个身世，他是一个恶魔。
His name was Ravan.
他的名字叫 Ravan.
And he was a great, powerful king.
他是一个非常有力量的国王。
And he had a great, he was the king of Lanka, and it was a very opulent kingdom.
在南卡，他是一个非那里有一个非常 美丽的富裕的国王国。
But he was killed by Lord Rama.
但是呢，他被 Rama 杀了。
So the next life he took birth again as a great king.
第二，所以下一世他又成为了一个国王。
Again with great opulence.
同样，他也有很大的富裕。
Almost equal to Krishna.
基本上和 Krishna 一样。
But not quite equal to Krishna.
但是不是那么的一样和 Krishna.
So it was always when somebody has more than you, you always, you know, you envy them.
有些时候我们总是非常嫉妒。
Someone's why they got more than me?
为什么他比我更多？
So Sishupal was always envious of Krishna.
西树炮总是非常嫉妒 Krishna.
Ultimately, of course, he was killed by Krishna again.
所以最终他又一次被 Krishna 给杀掉。
When he was finally killed by Krishna, then he went back. He went back to the spiritual world.
所以当他被 Krishna 杀掉的时候，他又回到了至尊人格首身那里。
So here, Dhruva Maharaj's mother is telling Dhruva, "Don't be envious."
Dhruva Maharaj's 母亲告诉 Dhruva Maharaj.不要嫉妒
and don't try to do any harm to someone.
也不要伤害他人。
You know, Dhruva Maharaj may feel that they did like that. They were not nice to me. I will get revenge.
Dhruva Maharaj, he will get a revenge.
Yeah.
Dhruva Maharaj 其实是想复仇的。
But his mother tells him.If you do harm to someone, then they will do harm back to you.
Dhruva Maharaj 的母亲就对他说，如果你伤害某人的话，他们也会反过来伤害你。
So better you just accept the situation.
最好你接受这种境况。
Just accept that this is the arrangement of the personality of Godhead.
就像我们接受 Krishna 啊，接受至尊人格首身的安排一样。
And what you should do is you should take shelter. You should take shelter of the personality of God.
我们应该做的就是脱避于至尊人格首身本人。
So this instruction from Dhruva Maharaj's mother was that this was the beginning of his.Bhakti of his devotional life.
而朱哈马尔吉的母亲给他的这个建议是他父爱服务的开始。
It encouraged him to take up, see it very seriously, the practice of Bhakti Yoga.
这让他非常在修习父爱瑜伽的时候变得非常的严肃认真。
We could say his mother is like the Varma Pradaksha Guru.
他的母亲是 Varma Pradaksha Guru,
means a teacher who shows the path. One who shows the path.
就是他向你指路的这个离心导师。
Just like in the beginning, somebody gave us a book.
就像在开始的时候，有些人会给人一本书。
And you get the book, and then when you read the book, you become interested and you want to find out more.
如果有人给你一本书，你就会变得有兴趣，然后呢，你会想了解更多。
So that person who gave us the book, they're like also a guru.
那个给我们书的那个人，他们也属于我们的一个 guru.
Because they brought us, they helped to bring us to take up Krishna consciousness.
因为他把我们带到了 Krishna 知觉中。
So the same way Dhruva Maharaj's mother.She is giving him this kind of instruction.
所以Dhruva Maharaj的母亲给了他这样的一个建议。
Now, when Dhruva Maharaj does go to the forest, then he gets another guru.
当Dhruva Maharaj去到森林的时候，他又找到了另外一位离心导师。
Then on the way into the forest, he meets Narada Muni.
在去到森林的这个路上，他遇到了Narada Muni.
And Narada Muni gives him mantra to chant.
Narada Muni 给了他一个曼陀罗，让他去唱诵。
To help him to chant Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
让他唱诵 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Narada Muni gave him also instructions what he needed to do, how he needed to practice.
Narada Muni 告诉他应该怎么做，做一些什么，怎么休息。
So Narada Muni is, you know, he's the Shiksha Guru for Dhruva Maharaj.
Narada Muni 是他的训士明心导师。
You could also say he's the Diksha Guru because he gave the mantra.
你也可以说他是他的启迪明心导师，因为 Narada Muni 给了他曼陀罗 mantra。
But the initial seed, the initial desire to take up bhakti yoga came from his mother. It was his mother who began the whole path of Dhruva Maharaj.
是他的母亲开启了他整个的这个道路。
So when Dhruva Maharaj later on, we will hear how Dhruva Maharaj goes back to Godhead.
在后面我们会了解到 Dhruva Maharaj 他是怎么样回归守神的。
And when he's going before he goes back to Godhead, he said, "Wait a minute, what about my mother?"
当他回归守神的时候，他就问那个人，他说：“我的母亲在哪？”
Dhruva Maharaj had gone to the mountain, the Himalayas. He was in Badrinath.And he was doing his austerities there, preparing to go back to Godhead.
Dhruva Maharaj 去到这个 Himalaya 那个地方叫 Badrinath， 他在那里从事苦行，正准备要离开，回归守神的时候。
And when the airplane came from Vaikuntha，
当来自灵性世界、来自 Vaikuntha 星系的这个飞机来的时候
，Then Dhruva Maharaj said, "All right, yeah, I'm ready to go, but what about my mother?"
Dhruva Maharaj 说我准备我可以随时准备跟你们走但是我的母亲怎样呢
And the people, the men from Vaikuntha who came in the airplane to take Dhruva, they said, oh, she's going in the other airplane, she's also going.
来自 Vaikuntha 的这个使者说你的母亲正在其他的另一架飞机上来自 Vaikuntha 的飞机上。
So the mother also, just because of her,doing this, giving this kind of advice to her son, it qualified her to go back to Godhead.
这是因为他的母亲给了他儿子这样的一个非常好的训示，所以他的母亲也变得有资格可以跟他一起回归灵性世界。
So, just a little effort to try to give devotion to someone can bring the greatest reward.
只是一个很小的努力，帮助他人，给予他人。Krishna 之觉也可以帮助我们回到这个灵性世界。
Prabhupada says, he quotes this phrase, a man proposes, God disposes. In the purport, Moshe Taitan, Chamshe Taitan.
在这个钥匙里面圣帕帕的说谋事在人成事在天。
Yeah. So, when Krishna sees a little desire on the part of the individual, then Krishna makes arrangements.
当这个我们个体生物有这一个小小的愿望的时候 ，Krishna 会做出安排。
So we need to get the blessing. We need to have the favor of the Supreme Lord Krishna.
我们应该对 Krishna 的这个至尊人格守神本人有那个热情，有愿望。要求他一下。
And to get that favor, to get the favor of Krishna, we have to really want it.
如果想要得到这个Krishna 的帮助的话，我们必须要有渴望。
So Dhruva Maharaj has to prove that he can be a devotee.
所以后面 Dhruva Maharaj 必须要证明他可以成为一个奉献者。
Not just, we cannot just simply say, "Oh, give me mercy, give me mercy."
我们不能只是说，请给我仁慈，请给我仁慈。
We have to show our genuine desire to get the mercy of Krishna.
我们应该展现出我们真诚的愿望，想得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
So, Sumiti, the mother, Dhruva Maharaj's mother, is giving the proper instruction. She's doing her duty as a parent.
朱阿玛拉吉的母亲 做了她作为父母的应尽的职责，给了她正确的训示。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, we read about Prahlad Maharaj, how he was instructed.
在圣典博伽瓦堂，我们也读到这个 圣帕拉德 Maharaj 他是如何得到训斥。
The Prahlad Maharaj was in the womb of his mother.
当他还在他母亲的腹中时。
And his mother was in the ashram of Narada Muni.
他的母亲呢就住在 Narada Muni 的修院之中。
So she was hearing the shastras from Narada Muni.
他从 Narada Muni 那里学习经典。
And because she was hearing, her child who was in the womb was also hearing.
因为他也在学习经典，所以他腹中的这个孩子也在学习，也在聆听经典。
So later on, Prahlad Maharaj was put in the Gurukula.
所以后来当 Prahlad Maharaj 被送到 Gurukula 临时学校去的时候
，But this Gurukula was not really for spiritual for devotees. It was for demons.
这个临时学校不是给奉献者开的，它是恶魔的学校。
And they were training the boys how to become good demons.
他们训练这个小孩如何成为一个恶魔。
How to become very materialistic.
如何变成物质主义者。
But Prahlad Maharaj told all the boys there.
但是帕拉德马哈拉吉在那个学校里面告诉所有的小孩。
Said, Komaracare Pragno Dharmam Bhagavatamiha. That from the beginning of life we should learn about the.Practice of Krishna consciousness.
他跟所有的小孩说，在人生的初始阶段，我们应该学习，如何修习 Krishna 知觉。
He said the human life is very rare.
他说人体生命非常罕见。
We should use it for the most important thing.
我们应该用这个人体生命用来做最有价值的事情，最有用、最重要的事情。
The most important thing is to develop our Krishna consciousness.
而最重要的事情是发展我们的 Krishna 知觉。
So we see Dhruva Maharaj that he has, you know, his motivation, his reason for going to worship God is for something material.
Dhruva Maharaj 他的这个动机是他崇拜至尊人格守神是想有一些物质的这个得益。
He wants to get a kingdom greater than his father.
他想得到一个比他父亲还要大的王国。
So he has a very strong material desire.
他有非常强烈的物质愿望。
And but because he's approaching Krishna, because he's going to Krishna to try to get that, it's also considered devotional service.
因为呢，他是向 Krishna 来要求这个愿望的，所以这个愿望也可以被认为。这个努力也可以被认为是奉献服务。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes four reasons why people surrender to him.
在国家梵歌中 ，Krishna 讲述了四种，人他们为什么会皈依 Krishna。
Chaturvidha bhajantimam jnana sukritino arjuna arto jignasur artarti jnani cha varad arshava.There are four kinds of pious people who come to Krishna consciousness.
有四种虔诚的人会来到 Krishna 知觉。
Some come in distress.
有一些是非常痛苦的人。
Actually, many come in distress.
事实上，很多都是痛苦的人。
The material world is a very distressing place. There's a lot of misery in this world.
在这个物质世界，就是有很多的痛苦。
And some people come in search of knowledge.
有一些人来是为了寻求知识。
Some people come out of curiosity.
有一些人来是为了好奇。
But Dhruva Maharaj, he's going to take up Krishna consciousness, and his reason is to get a kingdom. So he has a material desire. He wants some.Wealth. He wants a kingdom.
Dhruva Maharaj 来，他的目的是想得到一个比他父亲还要大的这个王国。所以他修习慧上知觉，在开始的这个时候的目的和动机是物质愿望。
And it's a very big desire. It's not a small thing he's asking.
事实上，他不是一个小的愿望，是一个非常大的物质愿望。
He wants to have a kingdom greater than Manu.
他想要比马努还要大的这个王国。
马努 is the father of mankind.
马努是人类的始祖。
So he rules the whole planet.
他掌管了整个星球。
But Dhruva, he wants to get a kingdom greater than that.
那朱瓦马哈拉吉还想要比这个星球还要大。
So he really wants, he really asks, he's asking for a big thing, something really big.
所以他的要求是非常非常大的。
You know, if you just ask for a small thing, you just ask for, oh, I need some money, or I need ten likes, or what, I need a million baht or something, you know, that's not much compared to what Dhruva Maharaj wants.
你们知道，如果你只是要100块钱，或者说1000块，或者100万，这个泰铢。这个事实上不是那么多的钱，相比于这个朱瓦马哈拉吉所要的这个财富。
But Dhruva Maharaj is asking for this huge kingdom, very big kingdom.
朱瓦马哈拉吉要非常巨大的一个王国。
But he in the beginning he was like this.
但是这只是他开始的愿望。
But because he met Narada Muni and he got good instruction from Narada Muni.
由于他从南无目的得到了很好的训示
，so he got a lot of purification.
之后他获得了很多的净化。
He chanted the mantra,
唱诵曼陀罗
，and he did a lot of austerity.
从事了很多的苦行
，and finally he became successful. He was able to meet the Supreme Lord.
然后在这个见到至非常成功的见到了至尊人格首身本人。
And when he met the Lord, then he realized he didn't really want the kingdom.
但是当他见到至尊人格首身的时候，他又觉得我不是那么想要这个王国了。
Because he understood if he was going to take the kingdom, then he would have to stay in the material world.
因为他知道，如果我还要这个王国的话，我还会留在这个物质世界。
You have to stay in this world of birth and death. You have to suffer.
我们必须还在这个物质世界里继续受苦，生老病死。
So Dhruva Maharaj thought, why should I want to stay here? I should try to get out from this world.
那朱瓦马哈拉吉就思考，我为什么还要留在这里呢？我应该走出这个世界。
I was foolish, Dhruva Maharaj says. It was stupid of me to want this kingdom.
朱瓦马哈拉吉就觉得自己非常的愚蠢，竟然想要这么一个王国。
What I really want is devotional service.
而我真正想要的是奉献服务。
That's the most important.
这是最重要的事情。
So Dhruva Maharaj, is getting this instruction from his mother.
所以朱瓦马哈拉吉从他的母亲那里得到这个训示。
To get instruction from the parents is.The parents, that's why we say the parents, they're also like the guru.
我们之前也讲过，父母有时候也是 guru.
Just like we worship the guru, we worship the spiritual teacher, we can also worship the parents.
就像我们崇拜灵性导师一样，我们也崇拜我们的父母。
Because the parents also give a lot of just instruction to help us on the path of spiritual life.
因为父母也给出我们很多的这个灵性的建议，在我们灵修的路途上。
And although it appears Dhruva Maharaj wasn't thinking about spiritual life, he had just simply material desire.
即便朱瓦马哈拉吉在开始的时候只是一些物质化的这个概念、物质化的愿望。
But because his mother told him, you have to go to the Lord, you have to go to the personality of Godhead, he's the only one who can help you.
即便朱瓦马哈拉吉是物质的愿望，他的母亲给他的这个建议是，只有至尊人格首神能够帮助你。
So because Dhruva Maharaj, because of his piety, because he must have had a lot of piety, he was able to accept this instruction.
因为朱瓦马哈拉吉有很多的非常的虔诚，所以他接受了这个建议。
Not everybody will take that instruction. Not everybody will accept that kind of instruction.
不是所有的人都能接受这样的建议的。
Just like we tell people, you know, if you chant Hare Krishna, it can solve all of your problems.
就像我们跟别人说，如果你唱诵 Hare Krishna, 它可以解决你所有的问题。
But not everybody will take the instruction. They want chant, but they say, oh, yeah, I'm not going to do that.
但是呢， 并不是所有人能够说能够接受你的建议，他并不也并不会去唱诵。
No, because they don't have any current pious activities to take up.
因为他没有太多的这个虔诚去接受这样的建议。
So where do these pious activities come from?
他的这个虔诚活动来自于什么呢？
It comes from contact with the devotee.
来自于和奉献者的联系联谊。
You have to have some connection somewhere with the devotee.
你必须在某些地方一定和奉献者有一些关系联系。
Just like in Damodar Lila, you have these two sons of Kuvera, Nala Kuvera and Mani Griva.
就像在达摩达尔这个逍遥时光中，有两个库维尔的两个儿子 ，Nala Kuvera 和 Mani Griva.
So they were cursed to become trees.
他们被诅咒成为两个树。
Because they were very sinful, very fallen.
因为他们非常的罪恶和堕落。
They were drunk and they were naked and they were in a holy place.
他们在圣地喝醉了酒。
And so Narada Muni felt disgusted to see them.
Narada Muni 觉得非常看到这一幕非常恶心，然后就诅咒了他。
So he put them into the tree body.
把他们投到了他们诅咒之后成为一个树的躯体。
But later on, they were able to meet with Lord Damodar.
但是呢，之后他们又有能力可以见到主达摩达尔。
Why were they able to meet with Lord Damodar?
他们为什么又可以能见到主达摩达尔呢？
They were not pious.
他们不虔诚。
They were really fallen.
他们非常的堕落和罪恶。
But
但是
by the mercy of Narada Muni,
这是 Narada Muni 的仁慈。
Because he had met Narada Muni, so Narada Muni, although he put them into trees, he also arranged that Lord Damodar would come and deliver them.
由于 Narada Muni 的仁慈，即便他们成了一棵树，他们还是能够见到主 Damodar.
And similarly, also Ajamila.
同样的道理，还有这个 Ajamila.
He was also sinful.
他也非常罪恶和堕落。
But somehow he named his son Narai.
但是由于某种情况原因，他竟然把他的儿子取名为 Narayana.
Why did he give his son that name?
他为什么会给他的儿子这样一个名字呢？
He was a very fallen person.
他这么的堕落的一个人。
But somehow he must have met some devotee somewhere. Some devotee had told him.Oh, when your wife has a child, give that name.
但是呢，由于某种情况、某种原因，有一些人给了他一个建议，给你的这个儿子取名这个名字。
So same way, Dhruva Maharaj is in this situation. You know, he's not really very pious.
所以 Dhruva Maharaj 的这个情况下。He's not pious.
Not particularly pious. He's angry.
他在那个情况不是特别的虔诚，因为他非常愤怒。
And he wants to get this kingdom. He's very ambitious.
他非常雄心勃勃的想要这个王国。
But somehow he's getting this good instruction from his mother.
但是呢，由于这个非常幸运的是，他得到他母亲的建议。
And she's telling him, you have to, only the Supreme Lord can help you in this situation.
他的母亲说，只有至尊人格守神可以帮助你解决这个情况。
So every situation, in every position, every problem situation we have, we should also think like this.
所以在每一个情况下，我们都应该这么去想。
That we have to approach Krishna. This will help us to overcome all the problems.
我们应该向 Krishna 去接近 Krishna， 他能帮助我们解决所有的这些问题。
The more we chant and hear about Krishna, then all of these problems will be solved.
我们越多的聆听和唱诵 Krishna， 所有这些问题就越能多的得到解决。
So Lord Chaitanya, he liked very much to hear this whole section about Dhruva Maharaj from Srimad Bhagavatam.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 非常喜欢聆听这个 Dhruva Maharaj 的这个这一段的这个逍遥时光。
He used to go and hear Gadadhar Pandit would read the Bhagavatam to Lord Chaitanya every day.
过去的时候，这个 Gadadhar Pandit 他经常给每一天给主 Chaitanya 阅读圣典波伽马的。
Lord Chaitanya would relish this wonderful lila, how Dhruva Maharaj became a great devotee.
说主柴太娘每天都在品味这个朱阿玛拉吉他如何成为一个伟大的奉献者的。
How he was so determined.
他是如何有这么强大的决心。
And although he was only a young child, he was very serious in his spiritual practice.
即便他是这么小的一个小孩，他依然那么有严肃认真地对待这个佛教之觉。
So,He got, initially, he got mercy from his mother.
他从他的母亲那里得到了很多的仁慈。
We say in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it said, Brahmanda Brahmite Konya Bhatyavanji, Guru Krishna Prasadi Pai Bhakti Lata Beach. That the living entity is moving through many different universes, birth after birth.
这个个体生物从一个星球生生世世从一个星球到另一个星球不断的迁移。
But when he's actually fortunate, then he gets a seat of devotion.
但是呢由于某如果他幸运的话他会得到奉爱服务的种子。
So this seat of devotion was planted here by the mother, by Suniti.
而这个时候奉爱福的种子是他的母亲 Suniti 给他种下的。
She's giving him this nice instruction to Dhruva Maharaj.
他给了他一个非常好的建议给 Dhruva Maharaj.
She also understands that Dhruva Maharaj's situation is unfortunate.
他也知道 Dhruva Maharaj 的这个处境是非常不幸的。
Materially, his situation is unfortunate.
物质的这种处境都不幸
because he is born from the womb of this mother Suniti and she is not appreciated by the father
因为他是由他的母亲 Suniti 所生而他的母亲并不被他的父亲所看好
There are so many unfortunate souls in the world today
在这个当今世界上有很多不幸的灵魂
There are so manyPeople, there's many like sometimes we see unmarried mothers. She have a child.
我们看到很多的这个母亲，她并没有结婚，但是她有孩子。
So unfortunate souls.
非常不幸的灵魂。
But they can become fortunate.
但是呢，她又可以变得非常幸运。
The unfortunate can become fortunate by bringing them to Krishna consciousness.
从不幸变得幸运是。他们接受 Krishna 可以通过 Krishna 知觉
Just like Parasara Muni, he was a great sage.
就像 Parasara Muni, 他是一个伟大的圣人
And he was attracted one time by a fisherman's daughter.
而他被一个鱼的这个渔夫的女儿所吸引
Right, that lady was Satyavati.
而这个女士是叫 Satyavati.
And Parasara Muni conceived a child in the womb of this fisherman's daughter.
Parasara Muni 可以拯救这个女士。
No, he gave a child. He put a child. He made her pregnant.
哦，他让这个女士怀孕。
Yeah.
给了她一个孩子。
And that child was Vyasadeva.
而这个孩子就是 Vyasadeva.
So Vyasadeva is a great.The one who wrote Srimad Bhagavatam.
而 Vyasadeva 是撰写圣典波伽马坛的。
Srimad Vyasadeva is author of so many Vedic literatures.
Vyasadeva 是很多伟大文献的撰写者。
But he was born in what seemed like an unfortunate situation.
而他是出生一个非常不好的这个状况之中。
His mother is just a fisherman's daughter.
他的母亲是一个渔夫的女儿
and father did, the Parasara Muni didn't marry her
而帕尔萨穆里甚至跟他都没有结婚。
But they had this child.
但是他有这个孩子。
But that child grew up to be Vyasadeva.
但是这个小孩出生之后竟然成为维亚萨内姆。
So unfortunate souls can become fortunate.
但是不幸可以转变为幸运。
It is said, Valmiki, there was this great sage who wrote the Ramayana, Ramayana, Valmiki, he was born from an anthill.
Anthill. 这个 Valmiki, 这个撰写这个 Ramayana 的这个人，他是出生于 ant,
ant,
蚂蚁。蚂蚁的躯体。
No, from an ant hill, 蚂蚁的山，那个山。
蚂蚁的山。
啊。
哦，他是从蚂蚁的这个山里面出生的。
Yeah. But he became a great sage.
但是呢，他也成为一个伟大的圣人。
So there are so many examples of people who have what seem like unfortunate births.
我们看到很在这个不幸的世界有很多不幸的灵魂。
We know Prahlad Maharaj was born from the great demon Hiranyakashipu.
我们还知道 Prahlad Maharaj 他是一个伟大的恶魔黑人亚卡西普所生，他的孩子。
But he became such a great devotee.
Prahlad Maharaj 也是一个伟大的奉献者。
So the unfortunate souls can become fortunate by the mercy of Krishna and Krishna's devotees.
所以不幸的灵魂可以变得有幸，是通过。Krishna 的仁慈和他奉献者的仁慈。
More merciful than Krishna are Krishna's devotees.
更仁慈的是 Krishna 和 Krishna 的奉献者。
Krishna's devotees will give Krishna consciousness more easily than Krishna will give.
Krishna 的奉献者会比 Krishna 更容易给予 Krishna 的这个仁慈。Krishna 不是特别。容易给予纯粹的奉献服务。
Because he knows if he gives pure devotion to someone, then he has to become their servant.
因为 Krishna 知道，如果我把一个纯粹奉献服务给予某个人，他就得成为他的仆人。
Just like he became the servant of Arjuna, he had to drive Arjuna's chariot.
就像 Krishna 必须得成为 Arjuna 的马车夫。
And he had to also.Take the message for Maharaj Yudhisthira, deliver a message for Maharaj Yudhisthira.
他还帮 Yudhisthira Maharaj 传信。
He became a postman for Maharaj Yudhisthira.
他是 Maharaj Yudhisthira 的这个邮递员。
So Krishna doesn't give pure devotion very easily.
所以 Krishna 并不是那么容易的给这个纯粹的奉献服务。
But Krishna's devotees are more merciful than Krishna.
所以 Krishna 的奉献者比 Krishna 更仁慈。
You can see Narada Muni, how you'll see in a few verses how Narada Muni helps. He gives so much training to Dhruva Maharaj.
我们可以看到 Narada Muni 给了这个 Dhruva Maharaj 很多的训示和这个训练。
And Narada Muni is also a guru of Prahlad.
Narada Muni 同时也是 Prahlad Maharaj 的训示弟，这个灵性导师。
Narada Muni is also guru of Vyasadeva.
Narada Muni 还是 Vyasadeva 的灵性导师。
So, Narada Muni is great teacher.
Narada Muni 是一个非常伟大的灵性导师，非常伟大的老师。
Giving the mercy to different souls to make them fortunate.
他把仁慈给予很多不同的灵魂，让他们变得幸运起来。
So we are also fortunate souls that we have contacted Krishna consciousness.
我们接触 Krishna 知觉，我们也是非常幸运的灵魂。
We were unfortunate in the beginning because we were born in the terrible Kali Yuga.
我们非常不幸，因为我们出生在卡利年代。
We were born outside of the Vedic culture.
我们出生在远离伟大文化的这种地方。
But somehow, by the mercy of devotees, somehow we have the opportunity to become fortunate.
但是由于奉献者的仁慈，我们变得有幸能够接触这个 Krishna 知觉。
So that, of course, we must have had some desire on our own part. We wanted it.
当然，我们内心也会有，也必须要有愿望去接受这个。
Krishna consciousness is being distributed to many people.
奎士那之爵被派发给很多人,
but only a few fortunate souls accept.
但是只有非常少的一部分人接受了这个。
So we are fortunate that we are trying to take up this message. We want to take it up seriously.
我们之所以幸运是因为我们如果会认真地修习这个奎士那之爵。
So we get a lot of instruction from Dhruva Maharaj.
所以我们也能从朱阿玛拉吉那里得到很多的训示。
From his example of determination.
通过他的这个榜样和他的决心。
We want to follow his example.
我们也想学习他的榜样。
Okay, any questions?
好，有问题吗？
Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Ichha Dvaisha Samutaina Dhanva Mohina Bharata. Desire and envy.
在《薄伽梵歌》中说， Krishna 说， 欲望和嫉妒。
We have envy, we envy Krishna, his position.
我们嫉妒 Krishna 的这个地位。
And we desire to be as good as Krishna or even better than Krishna.
我们的愿望是想要跟 Krishna 一样好, 甚至比 Krishna 还要好。
So, this is the problem.
这就是我们的问题。
That we're not able to accept to be servant of Krishna.
我们不能够想成为 Krishna 的这个仆人。
We think being the servant is not good enough. I want to be the master.
由于我们想成为这个主人，认为这个成为 Krishna 的仆人并不是很好。我们所以想成为 Krishna， 想成为主人。
We think to be the master is better.
我们认为成为这个主人会更好。
But we don't know that being the servant is even more enjoyable than being the master.
但是我们不知道的是，成为一个仆人会比成为这个主人更享乐。
And that was why Krishna came as Lord Chaitanya.
这就是主柴他尼亚降临的原因之一。
Because Lord Krishna saw that the pleasure of the gopis, and particularly the pleasure of Radharani, they were getting more pleasure than him. So therefore, because Krishna likes to enjoy, Krishna is the supreme enjoyer.
因为Krishna喜欢享乐，他是至尊的享受者，享乐者。
We also like to enjoy. But we sometimes forget that we can enjoy more by being the servant.
但是我们忘记了，我们能成为仆人，才能够享受的更多。When
we try to become the master, then we don't enjoy so much.
当我们成为主人的时候，事实上享受不了那么多。So
this desire and envy are the cause of our leaving the spiritual world.
欲望和嫉妒是我们离开灵性世界来到这里的原因。
As soon as we feel like that, then we immediately come into the material world.
我们一旦这么想，我们就马上回到物质世界。
So, in the spiritual world, there's no envy.
在灵性世界没有嫉妒。
And everyone desires for the service of Krishna.
而每一个人的愿望是服务 Krishna.
constantly control the mind, train the mind.
我们应该持续不断地去训练我们的这个心意, 控制心意。
To be the servant, to surrender.
让我们的这个内心臣服。
So the Srimad Bhagavatam is meant for people who have given up envy.
这个圣典博伽瓦坛是给那些放弃嫉妒的人的。
In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna also tells Arjuna, because you are not envious of me, I am teaching you this knowledge.
在博伽梵歌中，我们也看到 Krishna 告诉 Arjuna, 因为你不嫉妒我，我才告诉你这门知识。
But somebody's envious, they won't be able to understand this knowledge.
有一些人很嫉妒，他是无法理解这门知识的。
And if we envy others, then we'll have the greatest envy to Krishna.
如果我们嫉妒他人的话，我们可能会更嫉妒 Krishna.
Because Krishna's got the most of everything.
因为 Krishna 他是拥有最多的一切东西的人。
So when we envy some person, this is a reflection. This shows how much more we envy Krishna.
如果我们嫉妒他人的话，展现了我们嫉妒 Krishna 还要多。
This is why we're here in the material world.
这就是我们在物质世界的原因。
We have to give up this envy.
我们得放弃这个嫉妒。
How to give up envy? We have to see everything in relation to Krishna.
如何放弃嫉妒？我们必须看到一切都和 Krishna 有关系。
Somebody has maybe more money than I have.
有一些人可能他的钱比我的多。
Why? There's no need to envy them.
不必要去嫉妒他们。
We can think that they must have done something in the past to deserve this.
我们可以这么想，他们一定在过去比我们做的更多，所以呢，他值得拥有这么多。
Everyone suffers and enjoys according to their past activities.
每一个人遭受也好，享乐也好，都是通过他过往的活动所致。
So we can also think that people who have these material facilities, that they can also be an obstacle to spiritual life.
我们也可以这么想。 当一个人有这么多的这种物质的富裕之后，这也可能成为他灵性生活的这个阻碍和障碍。That
you have money, if money can stop you from thinking about Krishna.
你有钱，但是这个钱可能会阻挡你去想着 Krishna.
Instead of thinking about Krishna consciousness, you just think about enjoying your money.
他把想着 Krishna， 他没有去想 Krishna， 他把想 Krishna 这个时间去想着如何去享受这个钱去了，去如何用这个钱。
Somebody has a good education, they have more knowledge.
有一些人有很多的知识，受过很好的教育。
That also puts us more in the bodily concept of life.
这也能够 导致我们有这种躯体化的概念。
And we think material knowledge to be more important than spiritual knowledge.
我们会认为物质的这种知识比灵性的知识更重要。
So the gopis, they didn't know, they didn't have a big education.
所以这些gopi们，他们没有受过很好的教育。
But they were the greatest devotees.
但是呢，他们是最伟大的奉献者。
We also see all of the opulences, these material opulences, they're all temporary, they're all in relation to the body.
第三个我们也可以想，这些物质的富裕，它们其实是非常短暂的。
You're finished with the body, you can't take your money with you to the next life.
在你生命终结的时候，这些它会离开你，你不可能带着这么多的钱。去到另外一个地方。
We can't take our material knowledge with us to the next body.
我们也不可能带着我们的这些物质的知识到达下一生。
Somebody may have a very strong, powerful body.
有一些人或许有非常强壮的身体。
But then they will get old gradually, the body will become weakened.
但是逐渐的、逐渐的，他的身体还是会变得越来越老、越来越虚弱。
And similarly, the beauty of the body, very temporary.
同样，我们躯体的美丽也是非常短暂的。
So no reason to envy people who have more.
所以别人有更多的时候，你没必要去嫉妒别人。
We should understand everything in terms of spiritual knowledge.
我们应该经由这种明心的智慧，我们应该理解这一些情况。
So Dhruva Maharaj should be thinking like that.
所以朱瓦马拉吉也应该这么去思考。
That his mother was telling him, "You're unfortunate."
他的母亲跟他说，你非常的不幸。
You're born from my womb.
你是来你不是出自于我的，由我出生。
Because you were born from my womb, therefore you're unfortunate.
哦，因为你是我生的这个孩子，所以你是一个不幸的孩子。
But if you worship the Supreme Lord, you can become fortunate.
但是如果你崇拜至尊人格守神的话，你可以变得幸运起来。
And Prabhupada also said like that.
圣帕帕德同样也这么说。
He said in material life, he had one family, he had one home, he had a few children.
他说物质化的这个生活，他有一个大的家庭，他也有一些孩子。
And the relationship in the family was not very nice.
然后家庭的这个关系不是那么好。
People were not speaking nice to him.
人们对他说的这个话也不是很友好。
So then he left home and took shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
所以呢他就离开了家庭，去托庇于至尊人格守神。
And Krishna gave him a home all over the world.
然后 Krishna 给了他一个更大的家庭，
and gave him,
是整个世界。
And gave him many children who loved him much more than his own children.
然后给了他那么多的孩子，他甚至比他自己亲生的孩子还要爱他。
So Krishna replaced what he had in the material life.
Krishna 把他的这个物质的这个家庭给转换了。代替了
gave him much more.
给了他更多。
So Krishna puts us into difficult situations materially.
Krishna 把我们放在这种物质的处境之中，非常物质糟糕。
But if we keep our faith in Krishna and surrender to Krishna,
但是如果我们对 Krishna 保持有那么多的信心，同时向 Krishna 臣服的话，
then Krishna can change everything.
Krishna 可以改变一切，
can give us everything.
可以给我们一切。
Prabhupada said God is like someone with 10 arms.
这个 Krishna 圣帕帕德说，神意味着神就好像一个人有十个，就像他是有十个手的。
So if somebody with 10 arms wants to take away from you something,
如果神他意味着这十，如果有十只手，他如果想从你那里拿走一些东西的话，
We only have two arms.
我们只有两只手臂。
But he has 10 arms, so he can take everything away.
所以他有十只手臂，他可以把你的一切都拿走。
And if he wants to give us something, he can give us so much.
但同时呢，他如果想给你一些东西的话，他会给你更多，非常多。
Because he can bring so much with 10 arms.
因为他可以用十只手臂给你很多很多。
And we can only take a little in our two arms.
但是我们通过两只手臂，我们只能得到一丁点。
So we just surrender to Krishna.
我们只需要臣服 Krishna.
And see what is Krishna's plan.
看一看 Krishna 的安排。
Okay, any questions, Maharaji?
我帮我。的好姐妹问她，她修习奉爱瑜伽有大概半年了，就是专心念十六圈，但是她开了，就是说，但是她开了一个辅导班，辅导班就是有孩子们嘛，要 社会一般都是要有肉的嘛，然后那他如果不运营这个辅导机构了，他就没办法维持生活了。那他应该怎么做？就是说怎么样有这个过渡的阶段？
Good day. She asked for her sister, one of his sister, because and this lady have a small school and she practiced the bhakti yoga for half a year and every day chanting the 16 rounds. But for this school, many children in our traditional school, they should give the children some meat.So she feel confused whether she should give the computer. She don't know how to do, how to make.
Yeah.
If she don't open this school or class, she can't maintain her life.
Well, there are ways to give children nutritious food without giving them meat.
有很多的方法，给予这个小孩又营养的东西，而没有这个肉的东西。
It's not that you have to give children meat all the time to eat.
不是那么的必要，总是得给小孩子肉吃。
Prepare nice vegetarian dishes.
这个重点就是你得很好的去准备美味的素食。
With a lot of protein, a lot of nutrition.
有很多的这个蛋白质和营养。
People think you need to eat meat to get protein. It's not true.
人们认为吃肉只是为了可以得到很多的蛋白质，这不是正确的。
Yeah, people have to learn how to cook proper, nice vegetarian food.
人们应该学习。如何烹饪美味的营养的素食
？And actually, there are many families who would be very happy to have their children get vegetarian food.
事实上，还有一些家庭，他们也非常开心于他的小孩能够吃到素食。
There are more and more people who understand the importance of vegetarian diet.
越来越多的人，他能够理解这个。素食的这个重要性。
So if she was serving vegetarian food, she could attract even better class of people for her students.
如果呢，她能够提供很美味的这个素食的话，她甚至能吸引更多的人来加入到她的这个班级里面或者她的机构里面。
You just have to learn how to cook properly.
只是需要去学习如何更好的烹饪。
Good. You have to have faith in what you're doing. That what you're doing is the right thing.
而且你要对你做的正确的事情怀有信心。
You think just because you cook meat, then you're going to make your school a success?
你认为你做肉就能让你的这个学校办得成功吗
？You can have a good school without cooking meat.
你可以有一个很好的学校，不做肉也可以有一个很好的学校。
This
school only give the can offer lunch.
像一个食堂。
Like the kitchen, big kitchen. They offer the lunch every day.
You have the lunch every day. Okay. So, you can be a nice lunch. You can have a nice lunch without meat.
你可以有很好的午餐，没有肉的很好的午餐。
You have to learn how to cook.
而这之前，你得好好学习如何去做，好如何烹饪。
Prabhupada went to America.
圣帕帕呢去美国的时候
，People were not vegetarian.
人们都不是素食主义者。
But Prabhupada was cooking for them, and all the people were coming. Nobody was complaining.
但是所有人来吃的时候，没有一个人抱怨的。
They were very happy, very satisfied. They were eating more and more.
他们非常满足，吃了又吃，吃了又吃。
You have to learn how to cook nice food.
你必须学会如何烹饪好的食物。
Vegetarian is not just eat some green leaves and some rice.
素食不只是吃一些叶子和一些米饭。
You have to make some nice dal.
你应该做美味的这个豆汤。
You can have nice bread like chapati.
你也可以做很好的面包，比如说 chapati 之类的。
This kind of food, you make some chutney, some pakora.
还有 chutney, pakora 这个炸的等等。
Nice sabjis.
很美味的 sabji.
You can put paneer in.
你也可以放那个奶豆腐在这个三杯里面。
二十二呢？
啊，礼拜姑娘是这样的，就是说上一节课姑娘说是，就是说每个地区的发音不同，在念诵教堂的时候，音找不准是这个临时的。但是如果念教堂的时候，比如念着念着好多，因为快了嘛，就会把字。
Last time you mentioned that the pronunciation is not the most important thing, but if we chant sometimes quickly, even sometimes lack of the
concentration,
lack of some words, is that okay?
Well, no, it's not okay.
不好。如果你掉了这个词儿，肯定就不好或省略了。
我感觉好像好多人都会出这个问题，没有，我特意问一下。
But you're trying, you're chanting.
但是你试着，你好好的念诵。
You don't want to purposely miss words out from the mantra.
你的目，你在念诵的时候，你并没有说我要怀着想要把这个词念掉的这个动机和这个目的，你的目的不是为了念掉的词。
If you're missing words, it means you're not hearing carefully.
而你掉了这个词，只是带意味着你没有很专注的聆听。
Then your chanting is not done with proper respect. It becomes offensive chanting.
然后你的念诵并没有给予很好的尊敬，所以这会导致冒犯的念诵。
But offensive chanting is better than not chanting.
但是呢，不管怎么样，冒犯的念诵比这个不念诵是要好的。
So, yes, if somebody hears you missing words, yes, they will tell you, oh, you missed a word, you're missing out some of the mantra.
如果你念掉了一些东西的时候，有人会告诉你，哦，你念掉了一个词。
So then you can chant better.
然后呢，你会可以念得更好。
So there should be quality in the chanting.
所以念诵需要有品质。
And there has to also be quantity.
然后也需要有质量，也需要有数量。
Both are important.
质量。和数量都是很重要的。
So, try to be careful.
所以应该小心。
Hear the mantra.
聆听你的 mantra.
Okay, Srimad Bhagavatam ki
jai.